In today's devlog, we're taking a look at some of the things that we are polishing in preparation for the demo. Stuff like ability prices, saving your progress, and what will happen if Billy dies. But more about that later. First, I wanna show you some changes we have made to the tutorial. In the last devlog, I showed you the last part of our tutorial, where Billy and Mr. Sandman is about to run up and face the main villain of the game. But Mr. Sandman is pushed out by an invisible force, so Billy has to continue alone. Nick pointed out that the force wasn't obvious enough, and that it looked more like Mr. Sandman jumped out himself and locked the gate behind him. And since Nick got the most upvoted comment, we felt that we had to make some changes. So, instead of having Mr. Sandman land on his feet outside the gate, Fabian made a new animation where Mr. Sandman first lands on his back and then jumps back up on his feet again. So now, it looks more like something pushes Mr. Sandman instead of him jumping out himself. And in the last devlog, I also told you that we had a lot of technical stuff to fix and some game design choices that had to be made. One of the things we had to figure out was what should happen when Billy dies. So far, the player has been forced to open the menu manually to restart the game. We decided to not do anything super fancy here. So, when you die, a 3-second timer starts, and when the timer runs out, a text appears on the screen telling you that a nightmare woke you up. Then you get the option to restart or exit the game. The menu is similar to the one you had to open yourself, but at least now, it opens automatically and also gives you some kind of confirmation that the game is over. Something else we talked about last time was that we had to give prizes to all the abilities in the game. They all had the same prize, and that was not very interesting. So, we knew that we had to assign them their own amount of teeth, which is the currency of the game.
Fuck yeah!
But, instead of giving one unique prize to each ability, we decided to save some time and instead made 4 different tiers for the prizes. Common, uncommon, rare, and epic. So, depending of how good or bad an ability was, we could give it one of these tier variables, and then it would automatically get its prize. Something else that has received updated prizes is the outfits that you can unlock. We gave them the different tiers as well, so now they cost between 1 and 4 stars. Another updated feature is that the outfits are now listed by prize and not in the order that we added them, like before. So now, it's more exciting to cycle through them, as they keep getting more and more expensive. But as you can see, not all outfits are listed here anymore. Some of them are missing, and why is that? Well, some of the outfits are still missing a secondary attack. And if we are going to release the demo anytime soon, we have to cut back on everything that is not super necessary for the release. So, some of the outfits have to wait for a later update. And same thing goes for some of the abilities. Almost all abilities have some kind of bug that needs to be fixed. But certain abilities require more work than others. So, just like the outfits, they will also have to wait. And speaking of outfits, we have finally added a way for the game to save what outfits you have unlocked, so they don't disappear every time you start the game. And now, we are also saving the number of stars you have found, all your settings in the menu, and also what kind of outfit and color you played with last. I also spent some time creating a profile system for the game, so now, you have 3 different profiles to choose from. There's also a button for resetting a profile, if you should want to do so. The last thing I wanna show you for this devlog is something that primarily will be used outside the game, and that is the game's header, you know, the big image that is shown on top of the game store page. We knew that we needed an image like this, but the problem was that we had no idea what the layout should look like. Fabian made a lot of different tests for layouts, but nothing really felt right. I then remembered this old suggestion for header I made over a year ago. This was before the game was even called Billy's Nightmare, and our working title was Dungeon Dreams. We really liked the feeling in this image. So, Fabian spent a couple of days making this awesome looking image with a high-res version of Billy. It still has a similar layout as the original idea, but of course looks a lot better. At least, we think it does. But we'd love to hear your feedback. So, what do you think about the header? And is the title easy to read? Let me know down in the comments. And I'll see you in the next video.